Hello and welcome to CNBC TV 18's High Life, a show that will give you the taste of the most coveted brands and the most sought after experiences. This is your weekly guide into the world of fashion, food, fast cars, high tech and style. I'm Shivani Gharat and here is a glimpse of High Life. On the show today is the fitness mantra to live a high life from a celebrity couple. We also have fashion tips tailor-made for men as a part of our winter special. And for your culinary senses, we have golden ladoos. All that and more coming up. But first, let's take a look at the movers and shakers from around the world.
Royal couple Harry and Meghan Markle sent shockwaves across the world when they announced that they wish to step back as senior members of the royal family and become financially independent of the crown. A day later, the iconic Madame Tussauds Museum removed the waxworks of the couple from its royal family set. But from what it looks like, a major crisis in the family may have been averted for now. After a meeting with senior members of the royal family, Queen Elizabeth II said that she respects Harry and Meghan's decision to create a new life as a young family. Meghan Markle, the Duchess of Sussex, has reportedly inked a voiceover deal with Disney. This revelation comes days after she and her husband Prince Harry announced that they were going to step back as senior members of the royal family. We learn that Meghan has recorded a voiceover for an upcoming Disney project in return for the company making a donation to a non-profit benefiting elephants. The Oscar nominations are out, and even as Todd Phillips' Joker became the most nominated film with as many as 11 nominations, the spotlight is clearly on Netflix, which has nabbed 24 nominations. For the first time in the history of the Oscars, the studio with the most number of nominations is a streaming platform. Joker, Once Upon a Time in Hollywood, The Irishman and 1917 would be slugging it out with five other nominees for the Best Picture Award. Both Leonardo DiCaprio and Joaquin Phoenix have been nominated in the Best Actor category. Amazon founder Jeff Bezos is in India and he has donned a Desi avatar for this trip. He has been seen wearing kurta pajamas at most of the events he has attended so far. The world's richest man also joined a gathering of children in Delhi to fly kites with them on the occasion of Makar Sankranti. And now, that's some Desi swag from the man who believes that 21st century will be the Indian century. Jeff Bezos and his girlfriend Lauren Sanchez also hung around with B-Town celebrities in Grand Hyatt in Mumbai at a blue carpet event organized by Amazon Prime Video. Tanya Shergill, the first woman to command an all-men contingent on the occasion of the 72nd Army Day Parade, has won many hearts. Veteran industrialist Anand Mahindra is one of them. He took to Twitter to share a video of the officer. Mahindra said that the video gave him goosebumps. Swedish climate activist Greta Thunberg has got a pat on the back from the Indian business tycoon Kumar Mangalam Birla. In his annual statement titled 2020, My Reflections, My Learnings, Birla says Greta could well be the conscience of Gen Z. Tesla is all set to push the envelope further with its adaptation of artificial intelligence. Soon, Tesla cars would be talking to pedestrians, asking them to hop on or move out of the way. In fact, a video teaser was shared by none other than Elon Musk himself. Priyanka Chopra has backed another international project. The former Miss World will be starring opposite Richard Madden on Russo Brothers' upcoming drama series Citadel on Amazon. The series was originally announced in July 2018, but the plot details are being kept under the wraps. This follows last month's announcement that PC and Nick Jonas will be producing an unscripted Sangeet series for Amazon. Also, Piggy Shops and Hubby Dearest turned up the heat in the new Jonas Brothers music video called What a Man Gotta Do. This video features all the brothers and their talented, gorgeous wives, Priyanka, Sophie and Danielle. Yusaku Mizawa, the flamboyant Japanese billionaire, is looking for a, and I quote, female life partner to accompany him on SpaceX's maiden voyage to the moon. Mizawa has asked women to apply online for a planned matchmaking event. This comes days after he pledged to give away $9 million towards what he calls the happiness experiment. Mizawa has promised to give $9,000 each to those 1,000 followers selected at random from those who retweeted his New Year's post. Mezawa wishes to see if money can indeed buy them happiness. Hungarian winemaker Royal Takoji claims to have produced the most expensive wine on this globe. Priced at $40,000 a bottle, the limited edition Essentia 2008 decanter is a dream come true for every wine lover. That's not all. The vintage comes with an expiry date of year 2300. A 17-year-old NASA intern, Wolf Kukier, has discovered, wait for it, a new planet. Wolf achieved the feat by just 3 days into the assignment. The newly found planet has been located 1,300 light-years away from Earth, and scientists have named it TOI-1338b. Rachel, Monica and Phoebe have taken the gram by storm, and how? Jennifer Aniston recently shared an adorable picture with her BFFs, Lisa Kudrow and Courtney Cox, from a girls' night out. She referred to them as girls from across the hall. We wonder what Ross, Joey and Chandler have to say. American film director Spike Lee has become the first black person in 73 years to lead the jury at Cannes Film Festival. He will be presiding over the body of artists who choose the films to be awarded. Spike Lee said that he was shocked, happy, surprised and proud all at the same time. His recent film, Black Klansman, won the Grand Prix at Cannes.
And after that weekly dose of news from around the world, here is something for all you fitness buffs and just about anyone who wants to kickstart a healthy lifestyle. I caught up with Milind Soman and Ankita Konwar to talk fitness and how it is integral to a healthy lifestyle. Listen in. Milind and Ankita, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
So, tell me, how do you do it? Because, you know, I see you travel all over the world. Your India travel is also pretty extensive. And I see you running everywhere and, you know, doing some or the other activity everywhere. How do you manage? How do you find the time?
I think we plan it that way because we, in fact, sometimes we choose cities. We go travel to places just to run. And sometimes when we are just traveling for work or some other things, we just make sure that we find the time for ourselves, like probably an hour or 30 minutes, whatever. But we go out and run.
Milind, you have been, you know, a sports person. You have been a swimmer since your childhood. But you took on running pretty late in your life.
It's still 17 years.
Yeah,
but I've been running.
You know, when you know, you began running, what was the initial trigger? What was the motivation?
Well, this trigger for me to start running was, of course, the Mumbai Marathon, which was announced in 2003. And I felt that a marathon happening in my city is a great opportunity for me to do at least one marathon in my life. But as soon as I started with the half marathon, and I got hooked to it. And since then, because I enjoy running so much, I don't really have a goal. As in, I didn't start running to lose weight or something like that. I just discovered the joy of running through the first half marathon. And then I just made it a priority. So everywhere I go, I make sure that I have some time, even if it's 15 minutes or 20 minutes or half an hour, and I run.
What about you, Ankita? You know, you married into a family, like your mother-in-law, like at the age of 80, you see her casually walking 55 kilometers over the weekend.
Yeah.
You know, you've seen your sister-in-laws running, your husband,
yeah.
Milind. Like, you know, we know, like, you know, there are jokes and stand-up comedians, you know, crack jokes on him running, waking up one day and running from Mumbai to Ahmedabad.
Which is true. Well, I think it was when we started dating. So I would wake up like really late because I didn't have this kind of a schedule. I did not have discipline in my life whatsoever. So I would see Milind's post with you running almost like 20 kilometers. By the time I would wake up, I would see a post that, oh, I did 20 kilometers like in the morning. I'd be like, what? Who runs 20 kilometers every day? One day I went to my gym. So I used to keep fit, however. So I went to my gym was closed, and then I realized, I don't want to go back, I want to do something. So I just went for a run. It was 3 kilometers, but I felt so amazing after running. So I said, okay, I have to make this, you know, something, I have to put this in my life. So I started running right after that. Milind never asked me to run. Milind never said, oh, you should start running or do this or do that.
After you having said that, I have seen you, like, you know, transform into quite a runner over the past 1 year. In fact, you are running more mileage than Milind
yeah.
is.
Yes.
How does that feel, Milind?
I'm jealous that she's been able to find the time, more time than I can to run regularly. And in fact, when she did her first marathon, we were in Greece on a holiday. I think it was we were there for my birthday.
Yes.
And so we didn't really have any agenda,
yes,
but we were running a little bit. But we realized that, because you called and said, are you running the Athens Marathon? And we realized that the weekend after that was the Athens Marathon. We changed our tickets. I mean, that's how focused we are on, you know, really grabbing these opportunities.
Yes.
We changed our tickets and we ran the Athens Marathon at that time.
You know, whenever you don't run, how do you, manage to, balance that fitness in your life?
Well, for me, right from the beginning, it's been... not using elevators or escalators. It's a mental discipline, actually. So it's very easy for you to say, oh, I've got to go to the fourth floor, I'm taking the lift. In fact, you don't even think about it. You just go to the lift. But to actually think about it and say, no, I'm not going to take the lift, I'm going to take the stairs. It might take me 30 seconds more, but I'm going to incorporate this because it's going to help me. So anything like that, like if I'm going out of my house and I have to go like a couple of kilometers, I won't take the car or I won't take a taxi. It is a lifestyle. It's not about going to the gym for 2 hours. It's not really about running 20 kilometers. It's a lifestyle. So every choice you make, whether it's about your activity, it's about the food that you eat, the time you sleep, whatever those small choices are, those decisions are, it's part of your discipline. It's
Correct.
Part of your mindset.
And you know, one of the small difference or the change that I saw when I observed you guys is whenever I go to their house, I get treated with a lemon sharbat or a kokum sharbat with jaggery, not with sugar, but with jaggery. Or, a simple apple pie that you make at home, that is also made with jaggery. How has it impacted your life, Ankita?
Oh, it has in many ways. I would not pay attention to my diet so much before. Of course, I would eat anything. But then when I met him, I started realizing, wow, I mean, this is another way of life. And then I started paying more attention to what I would eat. I turned into a vegetarian. I've been trying to be vegetarian for a very long time. I struggle a lot. So I think these small, tiny little changes in your life and in your daily food diet, it really changes. It has an impact on you.
Tell me, in your crazy long day at work, how does this, running in the morning help you probably make decisions better or navigate through, when all the things around you are falling apart?
Well, obviously, it's well documented that sport or activity really makes you think clearer, it helps you to focus, it helps you to concentrate, it helps you to work through problems. But even when I was doing television, for example, in the 90s, and I wasn't really a runner, but sometimes I'd finish a shoot at, say, 11 or 12 in the night, and I used to run home. So I used to say that, I'm very tired right now physically, but and mentally, you get mentally stressed in the same environment, you've been doing something the whole day, and you want to release all of that. And I found that running could help me to release it. So even if you're tired, you're more mentally tired than physically. Your physical body can actually take up a lot more than you think it can. When you actually take out a little bit of time in the evening for a small run, it could be a 20-minute run, a half an hour run, it completely rejuvenates you. It refreshes your mind, which is the most important thing. I won't say that it's important to run at any particular time. I think it's important to run at some time.
Okay, you inspire and appeal to different generation, different sets of people. And many people must have approached you and mentioned how, you through your fitness journey, through probably your posts on social media, have inspired them to take up fitness. What, according to you, was the biggest compliment that you got?
I do get a lot of compliments. I mean, the fact that people are inspired is a very satisfying feeling. That I can be an example just by doing something that I enjoy, something that I love. I'm not going out of my way. It's not a struggle for me. A lot of people, as we know, they start exercise fairly late in life, by the age of 30 or 35. And the reason that they've started is because they want to lose weight. So some people come to me and say, I've been following you and I'm really inspired and so on, and I've lost 50 kilos. And in my mind, I'm thinking that how did you put on that weight? That is the shocking thing. In today's time, we're so disconnected from ourselves. That we don't, when we're looking in the, even looking in the mirror, we don't even see ourselves. We probably see what other people are seeing. Doing this kind of activities, these small exercises, running or whatever you feel like doing, it connects you with yourself, with your own body, with your own mind, get your mind and body to work together. And that is something that makes you more productive as a person.
Milind, finally, not everyone has like that 1 hour or 30 minutes of time in the morning to actually step out and go for a run. In such a scenario, what can the person do best within the limited 5 to 10 minutes that the person has?
Well, actually, there are lots of very, very short workouts online. I mean, if you just go on to YouTube probably, and you'll be surprised at how many combinations of circuits come up. So for me, I mean, a good circuit that I do is a 1 minute plank, 1 minute of as many push-ups as I can do, and then 1 minute of as many burpees as I can do. So that's just a 3 minute circuit, and I just do it once. And that keeps me, it gives me a good core workout. It's quite dynamic, it's quite intense. So you can actually find stuff like that that you enjoy. Actually, any activity that you do is going to help.
Welcome back to High Life. Now that you have been inspired to get on the fitness bandwagon, it's time for some guilt-free indulgence in some golden calories. Sohila Bajaj has discovered a place in New Delhi that sells a 1,000 rupee laddu. Yes, 1,000 rupees for one laddu. Well, it better be made of gold.
We're here in New Delhi, and to tell me more about this very expensive laddu, as I am super intrigued, is the owner of Gurchini, Mr. Gaurav Chauhan. So tell me about this laddu a little bit.
So we are using 24 karat gold work.
Okay.
So which is cost a lot. We are getting these leaves from South Africa. Mm. So it's from the Navan bullion. And we are using the pistachio, so which we are importing from Italy.
Why Italy though? Why not India?
Because they have the best pistachio in the world. Okay. So it's called brut pistachio.
1,000 rupees per laddu.
Per laddu.
How much does that turn out to in a kg?
It will come around 24 piece.
So 24,000 rupees
per kg.
1 kg. That's it, guys. No, I'm joking. That's a lot.
Yeah.
How many takers have there been yet?
In a month, we are selling like 40 to 50 boxes.
I'm just trying to ask you in a very nice way that is this laddu so expensive because the ingredients are so expensive, or because you're trying to just cater to a demand for an expensive product?
The ingredients are also very expensive, and the kind of clientele we have, so that's for them only.
Yeah.
And you must see the packaging also, the kind of packaging we do. So it's worth more than 1,000 rupees.
Hmm. This 1,000 rupee laddu in particular, when people come to the store, do you let them taste it a bit before they make such a huge investment?
Not this one. We have a display, but it's not available at the store.
Right.
So once you you place an order, so you'll get it within 1 hour.
Are you selling only in India or abroad as well?
We are selling pan-India, so we have main customers in Mumbai, Kolkata, Bangalore, Chennai and Delhi. And we are exporting also, so there are a lot of people who's coming from, like today also we sent 5 boxes to South Africa.
Hmm.
So we have a lot of clients from France also.
Are these laddu selling online?
Yes.
What traction is that getting per month?
It's around 40 to 50.
What is the price when you export it? Does it include taxes and exporting?
The price is same. Hmm. So then you have to pay for your export charges and all. Yeah, customs and all. So okay. The shelf life for that laddu is like 15 to 20 days.
Because if I was to get 1,000 rupee laddu, I'd have a little bite every day and make it last for 15 days. So this is what 1,000 rupee laddu looks like. This. And now I try. It's good. You can only taste a burst of the pistachio. Sadly, you can't taste the gold, but it looks really pretty. I feel really lucky. And I leave you with a question. 1,000 rupees ka muh meetha?
Wow, Sohila, that was a golden treat indeed. Well, Delhi reminds me of cold winter days and warm clothes. Hence, we decided to bring in styling tips for men who want to look stylish without looking stuffy. Sohila, take it away.
Today we have on board Sahil Marwa, a business startup founder. He got in touch with us, we discussed his styling needs, we then went shopping, and here are the results.
So my first question to you was that throughout my week when I'm at work, how can I, without going totally official, formal in suits and jackets, keep it crisp and casual but yet presentable at work?
So what I told Sahil was, the good news is that you don't need to wear a jacket to look formal. You can easily look formal as long as you're well put together and neat and tidy. Now you say you go to the gym a lot, you know, you're fitness obsessed. Yeah. So the first thing is you need a pair of slim fit trousers that obviously are not too baggy or too tight. It's winter, so you can look formal using knits. Either you can wear a knit over a button-down shirt or even an open sweater over a button-down shirt. If your knit is a solid color, you can play with prints on the collar of your shirt. Or if your knit has a print on it, then keep your shirt collar plain and a solid color. Does that make sense?
Yeah, sure. Also, my second question to you was that I do get to travel a little bit for work, which is like, you know, a quick day trip or 2 day trips. I want to keep it light, but I also want to look great.
The answer is bomber jackets. They are very in trend, they are crease resistant, and also a thing that plays a very important role is your shoes. So you can try a pair of tan color brogues. They instantly give a formal look to your otherwise could be casual attire.
You know I love my sneakers.
I do.
How can I make sure that my clothes are as good and as slick as possible on a weekend or a weeknight too?
So when you're wearing sneakers and you don't want to get out of them, just like Sahil, then you can play with prints on your shirt. You can get a nice printed button-down collared shirt that makes you look young. And in case even a button-down shirt is just too formal for you on a weekend, then you can play with polos. A full-sleeve polo, a half-sleeve polo. What do you think about that?
That's a great idea. I'm going to definitely play on with polos for sure.
As always, my style tip. Just as you saw with Sahil, your clothes should be an extension of your personality. Never the other way around.
Who knew you would look so sleek in sneakers if paired up with the right clothes? On that note, it is time for us to sign off. Keep living the high life.